your breath.
Well, his quote was, when you're in a competition, your strongest weak, your biggest weakness comes in the foreground. And he talks about how there's a limit to how skilled you can get as a shooter in the Olympics. And everyone is just as skilled as they all. There's a limit to how much you can get. And the person who takes home the medal that day is the person who has the right mindset. And the person who tends to make it.
Yeah, but you all of you know, why do you win this fight after so long doing any match break between? Anyone can tell me why does it happen sometimes? Why should it come to the point? Because your offering works only on that. He forces you to deal with things which are difficult for you. That is a strategy. And in turn, you force your opponent to the corner where you find it difficult. You don't force him to the corner where he is strong, right? There are some who are very good at the net, which can be competition for badminton as well as tennis. There are some who are extremely good at the baseline. So if a person is very strong at baseline, you go on giving wrong rallies. So you have to study that person, prepare yourself and deal with it. And you also be knowing where you are weak. So that is what is a game. It's not just how good you can play. If you take basketball, which you defend, how strong you are, that matters a lot. But that alone will not do. You need to make sure you also score. So in every game you play, there is a kind of strategy in psychology.
Right.
psychological jeweler based on animal psychology long-term. Okay, now, how did you get interested in animals in animal psychology?
I think growing up, I always had that, like, my house was kind of like a zoo growing up. Like, I had turtles, I had rabbits, I had birds, I had three dogs, I had fish. So it was like, growing up itself, I was surrounded by animals. And because my mom, she's also kind of coming from a family where they had a generation of dogs. So that's also kind of passed on to me. So I think that's how I kind of developed a passion for animals. Right from childhood, I've been conditioned to love animals.
Your love for animals must have led you to study something about them. That's how you study psychology?
Yeah, actually what I was thinking is I kind of want to go into human psychology, but then I realized by going into human psychology, I would be leaving behind something which I'm very fond of. I wouldn't be able to work with animals. So I thought I'm interested in psychology. Why not put them together into something great?
See, whenever you take a new domain, you'll have a lot of challenges. Like, all of us don't have the same passion, same passion, and we don't do so much of service members. You are in that realm. What kind of special challenges you face or you face? See, it would have been very easy for you to just adapt, get ready and come to school. Now I'm sure you have on your mind the idea to go to these fellows before I go to school. And as soon as you go back home, you're looking after them. Does it mean extra effort on you? And how does it help? What has been the challenge?
I wouldn't say it's extra effort on myself because it's something I enjoy doing, going and meeting the students. And yeah, basically going interacting with the state of my neighborhood. So
what does it mean? what context do you heard that word? Okay, everybody here? team. That you can't forget. Alright. Can you tell us something about a situation where your friends help you a lot or they are helping you a lot?
I think there are some days when I'm just down. Like I find the whole stress template, just generally it kind of gets me a lot of the times. And I don't go around telling people that, oh, I'm sad today, oh, I'm kind of dull. I kind of tend to internalize my problems and that's something I need to work on. But I really like to thank my friends for kind of noticing my words. Even when I'm not saying anything, they understand what I need to say. Like I don't say today actually this feeling that they look, one look at me and they know something's up with me. And I think that's really kind of helped me grow. My friends, they've really shown a lot of support to me and I'm really thankful for all of
you. Psychiatrist was not there a couple of decades before. Now, every country all over the world, they're all very busy. They're all dealing with the mental health of people, including children. So there's nothing wrong in taking help and becoming strong and happy. So that way, I think Anushka has got a nice understanding for all of you. Let's come to a bit of games. What are your favorite games?
Worked it out and he gave up. Any
any idea of what helped him to pick up once he started turning it around?
I think what helped him to pick up was he found the strength in himself. Like he says in the chapter, he's talking about how he kind of started plummeting, like he started dropping, and then one day he just realized the only person who can save him is himself. And I think all of us need to realize that no matter what situation you are in, no matter how hard circumstances seem, the only person that can save you is yourself.
I think Anushka has given us a kind of exemplary example for believing in yourself, having self-confidence, not giving up, to an extent struggling with what is going on, and then finding out ways and means of dealing with it, plus continue with your passion. And I also would like to request all of you to help her to feel more comfortable and help her to study a bit more seriously, because I'm sure with all these things, she may not be putting in her best. So particularly her classmates can help her. In fact, I want all the 10 students to help each other so that all of you can try. Don't keep it only yourself. I'm studying it, I don't do well, I don't worry about others. Those days are gone. Those days are gone. Now, there is a reworking of the story of the tortoise and the hare. What happened? They both finished the race together. So they both won. We always study for steady and regular work helps you. The tortoise maintained that the hare had to sleep because of overconfidence. That is a different story. But now the story is, though there is a competition, they realize they both can win. And that's how it works. And in any case, nobody can take your achievements out. If you work as a team, you definitely do better. And you always remember throughout your life how we all work together. It need not be everybody is sailing in their own boats. You can make a lot of changes to yourself. And I'm very thankful, Anushka, because he has brought out a lot of grit in what he's doing. He has brought out a lot of things which is not easy for a 10 at a time. And I know she has got a lot of guts and grit. That's why we ask to talk to all of you. I hope you all benefited. And if there anyone wants to ask one question, I covered most of the questions I got. Is there anyone? We'll allow one question from the audience, particularly from our classmates. Let's say from 10th standard, anyone can ask one question. Good question. Good answer.